Welcome to this brief presentation. My name is Maxwell Bjerg Pedersen, and I'm an information specialist at Aarhus University Library under the Royal Danish Library in Aarhus. So what I'm going to talk to you about today is how to engage students in web archival research. So I want to use myself as an example, since it's not that long time ago that I was a student doing web archival research. So my background is my master thesis that I did in the spring of 2019 within cultural history. And here I was exploring the possibilities and limitations connected to using archived web material as a historical source. And I'm going to present you with some of the obstacles that I hit. And these might not be at all new to you, so please bear with me. So the Danish Net Archive was the first obstacle, since it is a closed land for student. So my solution was the Internet Archive, where I could access what Danish pages they had archived. And since I had the material sort of in place, my next obstacle was the methods, because I wanted to utilize the digital born nature of the archive pages, not just look at them in the Wayback Machine. So my solution was to find a third-party software for extracting the HTML files from the Internet Archive, and learning coding in a statistical software program, in my case that was R, in order to do analysis on several HTML files at the same time. So by connecting these two solutions, I was able to look at the use of links within 2 points of a web page time. So I was looking at a political party's use of links in 1998 compared to the uses of links in 2001. So how do we ensure that students are intrigued by the web research? So my example shows that you need to be a good deal stubborn in order to pursue web search research as a student today. So I would say that one of the main problems is accessing archived web sources. So of course, one way is doing it through the Wayback Machine, but this only gives you the graphical sort of restored view. So I would advocate for making it easier for students to access more raw files, such as HTML files or VARC files. So in these terms, I would suggest looking towards traditional archives and their online activities. And a lot of these will have packages of digitized archival sources. So why not do this within web research and web archives as well? So one way I could imagine this being done is having a national web archive curate a package containing web pages that has been cleared of sensitive material or copyrighted material. That could, for example, be that of public authority, such as, for example, a country's foreign ministry, and the archive, the web pages connected to that. So this is good in terms of making the archived sources in some extent available to students, and still having control of the sensible material. And besides that, it's also a great opportunity for bringing up new researchers. And this is of course hard in terms of the online format, but I guess this points very well back to Ulrich's former presentation, Hand Me the Data. So I think it's also good for, you could give a few ideas for analysis like Python and R. And I'm not saying that you should teach Python or R. And I'm not saying that Wagner's role should be facilitating this, but I think it could be an idea for Wagner for sort of pushing these ideas forward of engaging students in web research. Thank you.